that is fairer than day. And by faith we can see it afar, and the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. To our bountiful Father above, we will offer our tributes of praise for the glorious gift of His love and the blessings that hallow our days. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. We shall meet on that beautiful shore.
A friend of mine tells me this story. I want to run it by you real fast. There's a guy named Mike Curtis. I write a lot of songs with him, have written a lot of songs with him. He tells me this. He said, you know, I was like you as a kid. I grew up in a small town. I'm from North Carolina originally. And I'm not sure what that means. Some of you may be from there. All right. I'm from Marshall, North Carolina, a little town, very, very small town. Anyway, Mike said he was like me, from a little town, too, and said, you know, I got in some trouble, too, not quite as much as you did, but said, I had two brothers there in the town I came from, and they got most of the blame for whatever went wrong or whatever went missing. And said one day their mom and dad decided to take them to the local pastor, let him talk to them, thought this would make a big difference in their life. He agreed, met him at the church. Took them back to where his office was, told the youngest boy to sit outside, took the oldest boy in his office, sat directly across this desk from him. He looked at the boy and said, son, do you know where God is right now? Boy said, no. He got a little louder, more direct, I guess. He said, son, I said, do you know where God is right now? Boy said, pastor, I done told you no. This makes the preacher mad, so he starts to scream. He said, son, you don't speak to me. And the boy jumped up, ran out of his office, grabs his brother. They ran out the back of the church, running down the road wide open, and the youngest boy said, what happened? What happened? The oldest boy said, God's missing, and they're blaming us.